And welcome again to this new session on the lecture series of linear algebra.
In this session, we are going to discuss about dimension of arrays.
So, as we have seen in our last session that arrays are used to store multiple values in one single variable. And if you have a list of items, then an array is a suitable class that can hold as many values under a single name. And you can access those values by referring to an index number.
So, in this session, we are going to talk about the differences between dimension, the size of the array, and the shape of an array, okay? So, first of all, we have to import NumPy as usual. Import NumPy as np, as we have seen in our previous session, we have been talking about how to create an array using NumPy. Okay, so we just have to use the array function now. And here, we can define an empty list or a list with entries. And this is how we can create a so-called one-dimensional array. Now, if we define an array like this, then we can print out the size of the entries. Okay. Of course, it is going to return with the number of entries here in this array. Okay. So let's run the application. Then, of course, the result is going to be 3. Yeah. Because we have only 3 entries here. Similarly, if we have 4 entries, we obtain the number here as 4. If we have 7 entries, then the size of the array is going to be 7. Okay. So now, what about the dimension? The so-called endim is going to return with the dimension. If we save and run it, then as you can see, it is going to be 1 because it is basically a one-dimensional array, right? Well, and what about the shape of this NumPy array? The shape is basically the number of entries in each dimension, yeah? This is why if we run it again, then of course in this case we have just a single value because it is basically a one-dimensional array, right? Would it have been a two-dimensional array? That shape is going to return 2 values here. I will show you after some time. And of course, every single value is the number of entries in that given dimension. Okay. So in this case, we have just the single dimension with 7 items. Yeah. So this is why we have a single item with value 7. Because there are 7 items in this one-dimensional array. By the way, the type of the shape is going to be a tuple. So if we print out the type of the shape, it is a tuple, as you can see here. So how to create a multi-dimensional array, which we also called as matrix? If we have, for example, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 2, 0. And then we would like to create the second dimension as, let's take some simple, say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. In this case, if we print out the numbers, then of course there's going to be a problem because we have to define the second dimension individually. In the sense, observe that we have used like this, but it is a wrong. We have to use something like this, okay? Basically, we have a one-dimensional array, and within that one-dimensional array, we have 2 one-dimensional sub-array, okay? This one and this one. Now, if we rerun the application, then as you can observe that one-dimensional array, So the outer array contains two inner subarrays. A one-dimensional subarray will use 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 2, 0. And another one-dimensional subarray, as we have developed this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So if we print out the size now, it is going to return with the total number of entries, which is 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 2, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. But if we get the number of dimensions, it is going to be 2 because we have 2 dimensions. Yeah, we have 2 one-dimensional array here, right? So basically, total it is a 2-dimensional array. Or we can also mention this as matrix. So if we call the shape function now, the shape function is going to return 2 and 7. Because basically we have 2 arrays, as you can see, and every single array contains 7 items, right? In the language of matrix, there are 2 rows and 7 columns. So if we print out M, so the array itself, we can take a closer look at this representation. And as I mentioned earlier, it is basically a matrix. A matrix has several rows and several columns, and in this case, we have 2 rows and 7 columns. That is why the shape's first parameter has something to do with the number of row in the data structure. And the second parameter has something to do with the number of columns. Okay. So if we use, for example, minus 1 here and 12 here, what does it mean that we are going to have 2 rows again? Because we have 2 one-dimensional array within a one-dimensional array, and every single one-dimensional array has 8 values. So basically, 8 columns, as you can see, okay? And by the way, we can get the given item based on indices. This has something to do with index 0. It has something to do with index 1. So if we want to get the first entry, then it is going to be returned 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 2, 0. So if we want to get the first item of the first array, that is 1, 1 entry, then we have to use the double rounded brackets here with 0, 0. And of course, the result is going to be 4. If we want to get the last value of the first array, that 0 will represent the first array, and then 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, that is 6, is going to represent the last item. Okay. So in this case, we are going to return 0. Now, if we want to iterate through this M's array, we can get that in, and we can get the given row, and we can use enumerate. That is what we are going to see now. So what is enumerate function? In layman's term, enumerate is often dealing with iterators. While dealing with iterators, we also get need to keep a count of iterations. Okay. And Python eases the programmer's task by providing a built-in function, this enumerate function, for this task. It adds a counter to an iterable and returns it in a form of enumerating object. So this is to give it as it has something to do with index 0, it has something to do with index 1, so we can get m's. And after that, we can print out the index, and if we do something like this, that as you can see, 0 and 1, because we had 2 one-dimensional arrays within a one-dimensional array. The 0 index has something to do with this subarray. Index 1 had something to do with this subarray. So if we now print out the row, let's run the application. And as you can see, this is the first row, this is the second row. So, if we want to iterate through all the items, then here we can define the item in row and we can print out the item, okay? In this case, we have to use a nested for loop, and by the way, in this case, we do not need the enumeration function, okay? It is optional. So, if we use something like this, I guess it is going to work just fine.
Yeah, so we are able to print out the values one by one. 4, 5, 8, 2, 0, 7. So this is how we can access the items within one or multidimensional array. I hope this part is clear. Apart from that, it is also possible to update the given value. Okay, for example, the second array, and we would like to manipulate the second item instead of
2,
we would like to insert, for example, 34. So let's run to see whether it is going to work just fine or not. So yes, as you can see, we have managed to update the value. Yeah. Also, we can increase the dimension of this array by inserting another parameter. So we have something like 7634512, and we rerun the application. So in this case, we have a three-dimensional array where every single item of the outer array is a one-dimensional array. Yeah. Again, we are given the values, and by the way, if we use the shape and rerun again, that we have 3 and 7. So 3 rows and 7 columns. Yeah. Now we are going to talk about the reshape function. You know, we can change the dimension of the underlying subarray. Yeah. It is absolutely crucial when we are dealing with machine learning related data sets, because usually these kinds of data sets need some pre-processing, such as normalizing the values, for example, transforming the values. And in this case, usually we need to reshape the data set. Okay. By that, what I mean that we need to change the dimension of the underlying array. We are going to talk about it in the forthcoming session. But what's crucial is that by doing this, we can define as many dimensions as we want. Also, we can define the dimension explicitly. Say, if we define something like this, say, let's take very simple, say 0, 1, 2. And we can define the so-called nd mini parameter that's going to define the dimension of this array. Okay. So if we now run the application with the shape, as you can see, it is going to have 3 parameters. And what does that mean? Okay, so that means that the number of values in the shape tuple is going to be the dimension. Okay, so in this case, we have a 1, 1 and 3. So there are 3 values altogether, which means that it is a 3-dimensional data structure. That is, it is the same as if we define something like this. We have an outer 1-dimensional array, then again a one-dimensional array, and within this one-dimensional array we have a model of one-dimensional subarray with 0, 1 and 2. So if we do the same and I copy paste it and rerun the application once more, then you can see it is the same. So we can use something like this, or we can use the nd min parameter in order to define the number of dimensions. Okay.